Hi, I'm Matthew Greaves with EJF Real Estate Services, here to talk about reasonable accommodations and how it affects condos, co-ops, and homeowners associations. As an expert in community associations and property management in Washington, D.C., we are exposed to the finer points of the Fair Housing Act and the Americans with Disability Act. When it comes to leasing properties in condos, co-ops, and homeowners associations, it's important to understand your role both as the landlord and as the association of what you need to do and how you need to act when presented with an accommodation request. One of the first considerations you need to make is to make sure you don't break the law. And so, despite your good intentions, it's not your job to determine the disability, but how to make action on the request. It's important to rely on the experts that you work with to help navigate how to make the accommodations if you can, and what you need to do. Often we find that the accommodation has a lot more to do with the community than it does with the individual landlord. So it's important that there's an open line of communication and an understanding between the landlord and the community on the actions they need to take and if the request can be accommodated. Working with a property management company that has the experience, the processes, and the understanding of the law will help you navigate these issues and make sure that your interests are best taken care of. Please, if you have any questions about this, come to us. We're professionals. We deal with this every day. We know what you're supposed to do and how you're supposed to respond. And we have all that information on our website. So please go to www.ejfrealestate.com and you can look under the Landlord Reference Center or the Board Reference Center for this information. Or just give us a call. I'm Matthew Greaves with EJF Real Estate Services.